Hello everyone. Today we will talk about a problem known as largest rectangle in a histogram. So we will be given one array of positive numbers, maybe zero also it can contain, and we have to form a histogram out of it. So if you see here, the length of the bar is actually the number. So 2, 1, 5, 6, 2, 3. And we have to find the maximum rectangle or the largest rectangle from this histogram. So this problem you can find in lead code number 84 also, largest rectangle in histogram. So what this problem is talking about? So we have to find the rectangles possible here, and among all the rectangles, which one will be the highest, we have to return that number. So in this case, this will be the highest rectangle of area 10. Why it is 10? Because the height is 5 and individual width will be here 1. So it will be 5 into 2, that's why it will be 10. So how to approach this problem? So first thing what we can do is, if we take any brute force approach, so we can calculate all the possible rectangles and then their area, and then we can compare. So that will take O(n) square of time. So what we can do is, if there is any other way where we can reduce this time, that we have to check next. So before moving to the solution, what I am doing here is, I have taken 6 different histograms, and from this histogram I will check from the result if I can get any common pattern or not. So for the first histogram, the result will be this particular rectangle. So this is the highest area of area 15, and if you look at here, the highest area will be this one, 6. So you can consider this area also. This will also contain the area of 6. For this histogram, the result will be this one, and for this one it will be this area, and for this particular histogram the area will be 8, this particular area, and for this one it will be also 8, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8. Or you can consider this area also, both of them will work for us. So if we look closely here, one common thing what we can notice is, for every result, the resultant area always contains one full bar at least. So here if you see, the result contain this 5 bar completely. Here also this 6 bar is completely present in the result. If you consider this area also, there also 3 will be taken completely. Here also 5 is completely present. Here 4 is completely present. And here also this 4 is completely present. And here 2 is completely present. That means what we derived is, the result will contain one complete bar. Always. You can check for any other histogram also. Now, what we can do is, we can calculate the area for a particular bar, and then we can compare at the last. So suppose if I have given this particular histogram, I can calculate for 7 what is the maximum area we can cover. For 7, the maximum area will be 7 itself, right? It can't form any other rectangle. For 5, it is 15. For 9, it is 9 only. And for 3, it will be this particular area. So it will be 1, 2, 3 and 1, 2, 3, 4. 4 into 3, 12. So the highest one is this one. So our approach will be, we have to find for every bar what is the maximum area it can cover. So for a particular bar, if I have to calculate what is the maximum area it can cover, how we can derive that? That will be our second step. So we will look at here closely. So for 5, how we are getting this area? So for 5, we are checking left side if anything is bigger than 5 or not. So here actually 1 is less than 5, so 5 can't proceed to the left anymore. So for 5, the highest left is 2, and for 5, the highest right will be 3, because 6 is greater than 5, so we can proceed this side. Then we can't further proceed because 2 is less than 5. If instead of 2, 5 is there, then 5 can proceed. But as it is 2 less than 5, that's why 5's right side upper boundary is this much only. So for every bar, we have to find the left side and right side boundary. So find lower bar in left and find lower bar in the right. So for a particular bar, if we can get a lower bar in the left or lower bar in the right, then only we are done. Because see, for 5, left side the lower bar is 0. That means the boundary will be here only. For 5, right side the lower boundary is here only because 4 is less. So for 5, this particular bar, the area highest will be 5 itself. But for 4, that is not the case. For 4, left side 5 is there. It can contribute to its area. But after that 0 is there. So 4 can't proceed. And right side it will be 1. So we got find lower bar in left and find lower bar in the right. Next thing is, when we will get the left and right, then how we will calculate the area? That is simple. What we will do is, we will do right minus left plus 1 into the bar height. So the formula will be right minus left plus 1 into bar height. So here in this case, right is 3, left is 2. That means 3 minus 2, 1. 1 plus 1, it will be 2. 2 into 5 if we do, that is the bar height, then it is 10. So the area we got. So for any other histogram also, you can check this one. So what we got from the previous section is, the result will always contain a complete bar, and we have to find the lower or the lower left bar and the right side lower bar. And then we have to calculate area of that individual bar. And at last we have to compare between all the area and we have to declare which one is the highest. So when we have to calculate the left side limit of a bar or right side limit of a bar, we have to hold the data into some data structure. And same case for area also. So what we can do is, we can define three array. One is left, right and area, and their length will be equal to the histogram length. So at the end of the video, I will discuss how we can reduce this area also. For understanding purpose, you just think like three array we have to declare. Now what you have to do is, suppose for this particular bar 2, we have to calculate the left bound and the right bound. So what you have to do? Initially, one for loop or any loop we have to maintain, which will traverse from one bar to another bar. But when we reach to this bar, if we have to calculate what is the left side minimum bar than this, then we have to come through this and we have to come here. Same case for right also. So if we have to reduce that time, how we can achieve that? So for that purpose, we can maintain one stack where previous smallest bar or any other information will be kept, and then it will be easy for us to take the record. So I will first start with how to get the left limit. So for that purpose, we will follow this three or four things. If stack is empty, make left as 0. If current bar, suppose this current bar is less than equal to stack top, then we have to keep on popping. Okay. And then for any run, we have to push the current index in the stack. And if stack is not empty, then left will be stack top plus 1. So many words, right? No need to remember anything. When we'll start this thing, you will gradually understand. So first thing what you have to do is, for this bar 2, what is the left side minimum element? As it is a starting point, so that's why there is no left. So we will simply say this bar itself is the last left limit. So left for this will be 0. So that is the thing actually talked here also. If stack is empty, means this stack, then make left as 0. In other way actually. So then for every run, what you have to do is, the current bar's index position we have to store in the stack. So here I will put 0, as we have visited 0 now. Okay. Next we will move to 1. So this is done. So next we will move to 1, and here what we have to do? So here I have to check what is the top of the stack. Top of the stack is 0. That means this bar. So height of this bar is greater than 1. That means we have to pop this one from stack. This is the second statement here. Because this is not the ultimate left. So ultimate left for this bar will be something less than this one. So as I am not getting here, I have to pop it. So I'll remove it from here. Then I have to check. Then what we can see from here is the stack became empty. So we have to follow this rule. So as the stack is empty, so we'll mention 0 here and we'll move on. We have to put this index here and move on. So ultimately it is true also, right? Because for 1, if you see, left side is 0 only. So ultimately the ultimate left for 1 is 0. Then we have to move it to 5. So in case of 5, I have to check the top of the stack, that is 1. So this one. So it is less than 5. So as it is less than 5, that means this is the maximum limit of left for 5. So what we will put here is top of the stack plus 1, this one. So top of the stack is 1 plus 1, that will be 2. Then we will move to 6. For 6, again we will check, sorry, I have to put the visited node here. So top of the stack is 2 now, that is 5, which is less than 6. So that means this will be top of the stack plus 1, 2 plus 1, it will be 3. And then we have to push 3 in the stack. Then we'll move it to the next, 2. For 2, we will check the top of the stack, that is 3, that is 6. So 6 actually is greater than 2. That means we have to start popping. Now top of the stack is 2, 5, that is also greater than 2. Then we have to pop again. Then we got 1. 1 is less than 2 actually. So we can put this 4 here, top of the stack. So before putting, actually we have to check which one is the top of the stack. So that time the top of stack was 1. So the result will be 1 plus 1, that is 2. And as we pushed 4, so no need to do again. So then we'll move it to the last one, 5. So for 5, if you check here, top of the stack is 4. So top of the stack is 4 means the value is 2. Okay, so 3 is actually greater than 2. That means simply top of the stack plus 1. So here it will be 5. Okay, so now we calculated each and every left value. Okay, so now we have to calculate all the right side limits. So for that purpose we will use this set of things. So I have to use this stack again. Okay, so what we can do is, after calculating left, to make use of the same stack, we can clear the stack. So I will just simply clear the stack for our next run, and I will remove this one also. Now the rule is, if stack is empty, make right as n minus 1. This is correct only, right? For by default, further left, it will be 0. But if I have to start from here this time for calculating right, so if my right maximum will be 5, that is n minus 1, n is the number of element. And current bar formula also will be same, that will be less than equal to stack top, then we have to keep popping and push the current index in stack, that is also same. So if stack is not empty, then left will be now stack top minus 1, because we will move from last to first. Okay, so the bar size, if it is increasing or decreasing, that time we have to do stack top minus 1. Okay, so if we do now, you will understand. So first I will start with this bar, 3. And right side of 3, there is nothing there. This is the upper limit. So that's why it will be 5. Okay, and we will put 5 in the stack. And if you check, 5 is actually n minus 1 also. Now we will move it to here and we will check what is top of the stack, that is 5. So 5 position 3 is present. So 2 is actually less than 3. That means we have to pop. So we have to pop this one. Now what we can see is our stack became empty. So if stack is empty, then we have to put n minus 1. That is 5. And then we have to push this index. Next we have to move to 6. So top of the stack is 4. So fourth position actually 2 is present. So 6 is actually greater than 2. That means for 6, the right side limit will be this one only. So that is stack top minus 1. That will be 4 minus 1, 3. So we have to put 3 here. Okay, and we have to push 3 in the stack. Now we have to go to 5. For 5, top of the stack is 3. So for 3, the value is 6. So 5 is actually less than 6. That means 5 can move. So we have to pop this. And then the top of the stack is 4. So 5 is actually greater than 2. That means that will be the limit. So it will be 4 minus 1, 3. And we have to push this 2 in the stack. Next one will be there. So for 1, we will check top of the stack, that is 2. So for 2, the value is 5. 1 is actually less than 5. That means 1 can move. So we have to that time delete top of the stack. So next element is 4. So 4 position 2 is present. So 1 is less than 2 also. That means we have to delete this one also. Now the stack became empty. That means in the position of 1, the right will be n minus 1. That is 5. So this will be 5. And it is true also. For 1 actually, 1 can stretch up to this one. So last position, that is 5. So we are calculating correctly. And we have to push 1 in the stack. Then we will go to the 2, the last one. So for this also, the top of the stack is 1. So 2 is greater than 1. That means nothing to move. And 2th position will be top of the stack minus 1. So 1 minus 1, that will be 0. Okay, so now we are done. So we got all the left and right side value. Now we have to calculate the area. So formula for area is right minus left plus 1 into the bar height. So for 2, it will be 0 minus 0 plus 1, that will be 1 into 2. So the area will be 2. For this one, 5 minus 0 will be 5 plus 1, 6. 6 into 1, it will be 6. For this one, it will be 3 minus 2, 1. 1 plus 1, 2. 2 into 5, it will be 10. And for this one, it will be 3 minus 3, 0 plus 1, 1. 1 into 6. It will be 6. Then for this one, 5 minus 2, 3. 3 plus 1, 4. 4 into 2, it will be 8. And for this one, it will be 5 minus 5, 0. 0 plus 1, it will be 1. 1 into 3, it will be 3. So, now we got the area for each and every bar. Okay, so how much area it can cover in as a rectangle. So, the highest area we got is 10. So this will be our result, and that is stretched from 2 to 3. Okay, so this is our result. We can verify few others also. Suppose for this 4, it is stretched from 2 to 5 and the area is 8. So, okay, so if you check, this is the area and the total area is actually 8, correct only. So this is the way we can calculate the maximum area in a histogram. So now how we can reduce some space complexity is, suppose instead of taking this area array, we can simply keep on max area variable, and every time we can calculate and update if the result is greater than the previous result, and then at the end we will get this result. So no need to take one area array. For calculating and showing purpose, I just shown this as an array. And what we can do is, for left and right, instead of taking two array, by applying some tricks you can overwrite the value up left. Means when you are calculating right, so that time you just calculate and keep it, so that time area array will be required. Okay, so you can keep on doing all these things in a same loop. Okay, so that also you can do. So for understanding better, I just explained in left, right, and then area. Now if we talk about complexity of this problem, so to traverse this left and calculate all the left, you will need O n of time, and for right also it will need O n of time, and for calculating the area also and getting the maximum also you need a O n of time. So if all O n together, if you add, that will also become O n. So now we will do the coding. So now we will start with the coding. So here I have defined one maximum area histogram class, and I have taken a main method. So there I have defined the histogram array, and I have defined one another method where actually we will calculate the maximum area. So as a bonus, actually you can say I have created one method which will print the histogram. So you can go through this code later. So it will just simply print the histogram for you if you are passing this array. Okay. If you are passing this array, it will print the histogram for you. Okay, you can check the code actually later on. So I will keep it in the downside, and I will start with the actual method. So what we can do is, first we have to define one stack, right? So what we can do is, we will define one stack to calculate the left and right. Will be new stack. Now I will check the length of this array using hist dot length. So one thing to measure here is, if the length is 0, then we will simply return 0. The area calculated will be 0. And if n is equal to 1, if the length is 1, then we can simply return the histogram 0th position value. That will be the result. Now we have to define the left array, that will be of length n, and right array, that will also of length n. Then we will take one variable called int maximum area, okay, which will be initialized to 0. So initially what we can do is, before entering into the loop, we can make left as left 0th position as 0, and then we will push it to the stack. So stack dot push, we will make 0, if you remember the first element in the left side. Then we will increase, then we will take one counter variable and we will start it from 1. Okay, now what we have to do is, we have to start one loop. So we'll take a while loop, and that will be I less than n, till then it will go on. So first thing is, if my left side element, sorry, means the top of the stack is means from my current element actually, if it is less than or equal to the stack top, then we have to keep on popping. Ultimately we get the correct one. So what we can do for this is we have to obviously check if the stack is not empty. Till that only we have to do this operation. If stack not equal to empty, and then if histogram ith position element less than equal to the histogram stack dot pick that element, then we have to stack dot pop, we have to keep on popping those element. So here I am using the pick method, not the pop one. Pick will only check for the top method, top element, not it will remove. Okay, then that part is done, and then we will check. So we have to assign the value for left I, right? So what we will check is if stack is empty actually. Suppose the stack is empty, then we'll put 0, or else we'll just stack dot pick plus 1. I'm just going through the logic only, which I explained. Then we'll push that element. We'll push that element I, and then we have to increase the value of I. So what I can do is we can use a post increment. So actually in the stack it will push the I, then it will increment the value of I. Now for all the left will be calculated. Okay, so then next what we can do is we have to calculate the right. So before that we have to clear the stack. We will make use of the same stack, and in this case our I will be n minus 1. From reverse we have to come. Then right of I, that means the last element, will be I. So that means the last element, for that the right will be the length minus 1. That is the thing I am doing, and we have to push this one in the stack. So we have to push I, and then we have to decrease. So I will use a post operator. So it will push I in the stack, then it will decrease, because we have to do the other work. So here also same thing. Here I will check not I less than n. Here I will check if I greater than equal to 0 or not, because we are decreasing the value of I and we are coming to the end, 0th index. So the condition will be different here. And then for stack related thing, we will check the same thing. Okay, same thing we will check here also. Yeah, and for write, what we will do is, I'll do the changes in this code itself. So now we have to change for the write. And if stack is empty, then we will put what? Length minus 1, not 0. And instead of plus 1, it will be minus 1. And then we have to do stack dot push, and it will be I minus minus now. Okay, so left and right is now calculated. Now we have to go for the result. So integer z equal to 0, some for loop we have to define, which will go through all the left and right, and it will calculate. Okay, so we can calculate the area. Okay, so for that purpose we can define one area variable, integer area equal to 0. So area will be right of z minus left of z plus 1, and then multiplied with that bar length, that is h of j. And if this current area is greater than the max area, then we have to update the max area equal to area. Okay. And at last we have to return this max area. So that's it. Now we have to run this. Okay, I have to print this. So we have to call this method, or we can print one beautiful message here. Okay, so we are calling this, and then we have to check. Yeah, so the maximum area we got is 10. So that's it about the code. So you can play with any input and check. And this code description I will put in the comment box. And you can put this solution in Git LeetCode also and can check. So now we'll quickly put our solution in the LeetCode also and can check if everything is fine or not. So I just copied it from there and pasted here. Then we'll submit. Yeah, so it is working. You can check. Thanks for watching.